what the Puritan tiger beetle needs is that eroding cliff face and these sandy beaches.
Adult beetles usually mate and also feed on the beach at the base of the cliff, and then the female flies up and lays the eggs in the cliff where the larvae develop. But they don't lay it just anywhere. The bottom part, sort of a clayey layer, bottom two-thirds, and the top maybe third, top 30 feet, is an orange-yellow sand layer. It's that orange-yellow sand layer that they use. They're predators. They eat other insects and crustaceans. Also, they're eaten by some larger predators like robber flies and birds.
The biggest threat to this species is building these shoreline erosion control structures. You can see the vegetation coming in behind it. So it is actually reducing some cliff erosion.
But it's destroying habitat. The tiger beetle, Puritan tiger beetle, needs a bare cliff habitat. That's where it lays its eggs. That's where the larvae develop for 2 years. And we're no longer finding adult beetles right here because the larvae aren't surviving.
It's not just impacting species like the Puritan tiger beetle. It's impacting species like diamondback terrapin, you know, things that need that natural shoreline. We have some of the best data in the country for an insect, and it makes our job so much easier to have that long-term monitoring data to be able to look at the trends in the species and to know how the different subpopulations are doing, especially now that we do have some of these revetment projects where we're losing habitat.